In this lesson, we shall focus on trigonometry grade 12, and we begin with questions as follows. Trigonometry exercises, we're looking at 5.3. Evaluate without using a calculator. This summation here, try this question and send me the answer, please. Try this question and send me the answer, please. Write this question and send me the answer, please. Okay, we're still here. Write this question and send me the answer. The sum of 38 degrees or 52 degrees, cosine of that. All right. Thank you for using the charts. Use the charts. Use the charts. I can actually say here. Okay. Use the charts. You can chat to us. Okay. I want us to start off by actually discussing what needs to be done in this particular problem here in terms of how we start and how we actually can be in a position to move forward in solving this particular problem, but solving this particular problem in a wide range of ways that will allow us to master every part of the exam that remains very, very important. So we start off by the summation. So we actually start off by saying we have cosine squared of 38 degrees, cosine squared of 39 degrees, cosine squared of 40 degrees. Cosine squared of 41 degrees. Cosine squared of 42 degrees. Right, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, and so on, up to cosine squared of 52 degrees. Okay, so this is what we have. Up to cosine squared of exactly 52 degrees. Right. 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 So what we have the for we have then the following. We then have the following. Cosine 38 is the same as what? Right, so if you look at 38 degrees, the 38 is the same as 90 degrees minus 52 degrees plus cosine squared of 90 degrees minus 51 degrees. Right, and so with this, just writing the first three. So you can write 52, 51, 50. Cosine squared 50. 51, 52 degrees. So that then in the end, you'd have also, if you look at the 38 and the 52, so you can say 52 minus 38 plus 1 would be plus 1 degree. It's exactly the same as what? So it would be, okay, we're looking at 52 minus 38 plus 1. So this is going to give us 15 degrees, yeah? Good. It's going to give us exactly 15 degrees. So if this gives us 15 degrees, it means therefore 15 is the same as 14 plus 1 is 2 times 7 plus 1, meaning that we're going to actually pair this up. So that this is exactly the sine squared of 52 degrees. The sine squared, 90 minus 52 is in the first quadrant, but there's a cost function change there. And this is 90 minus 51 is the same as what exactly? So then, if we say 90 minus 51 is exactly the same as 39 degrees, giving us sine squared of 51 degrees, there's going to be one extra term here that has not been paired. Okay, so this one here is going to be the sine squared of 50 degrees plus dot 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 plus cosine squared of 50, 51 cosine squared of 52 degrees. So this means that we have sine squared of 52, you can add it to cosine squared of 52 sine squared of 51 cosine squared of 51. Sine squared of 50, cosine squared of 50. So now you'd have, but now there's going to be only one angle that is going to be remaining. Now there's 38, from 38 to 52. There's going to be cosine of cosine squared of 45 degrees. Okay, because there's a special angle between 38 and 52, which is 45. Meaning you're going to have these. So, but these pairs here would be seven pairs. With this one, so it's going to be 1 plus 1 plus 1. Okay, so this would be 7 of the ones. Okay, let's do this. Seven of the ones. It's going to be seven plus. If you square that, which would be actually exactly seven and one half. Right. So, okay. So, on average, this is what we're gonna have here. This is what we're gonna have here. And so we think about this. Right. We then think about this. So the answer would be exactly, you could also use 7.5, but 7.5 is the best. 7.5 is the best. Right, in which case, therefore, you can think about it and make sure you understand it. Let's try the next question. Okay, these we have solved. And we're able to make sense of these. You're able to make sense of these. Let us then move to the next question. Five point 3.1, we need to prove this. So let the left-hand side, A plus B minus the minus, which is an A cosine B, so it's an A cosine B. Cosine A sine B minus this one is going to be sine A cosine B cosine A sine B. Cosine A sine B minus sine A cosine B plus cosine A sine B. But sine A cosine B cancels out. Cosine A sine B cosine A sine B, it's 2 cosine A sine B, which is equal to the right-hand side, which is this. Which is exactly that. So now we need to do this one. Prove without the calculator that this sine 77 minus the sine of 53 is equal to the sine of 17 degrees. We're going to take the sine. So let's take aside the left and the right. So let us let the left-hand side. Okay. Okay, good. Let us slow down. Okay, we are very slow now. Let us slow down. Let us slow down. Now, we want to prove that the sine of 77 minus the sine of 43 is the sine of 17 degrees. So, we want to prove this. So, how do we prove this? Right? How do we prove this? So we want to use this identity. And with these, it means therefore that whenever you have A plus B, A plus B is the same as 77 degrees. A minus B is 43. If you add them up, A plus A is what? Which is 120 degrees. So, which means that if you add these two equations, you get 70, 77 plus 43 is 120 degrees. Divide by 2, you have 60 degrees. If A is 60 degrees, you put it there. The A is 60. B is 17 degrees. So, which means that here you're going to write the sign. The 77 is A plus B. A plus B minus. So, we're going to use this identity. So, now the 77 is like A is 60, the B is 17. Okay, 60 plus 17 is what? It's 77. 43, the A is 60, the B is 17. 60 minus 17 is 43, which is 2 cosine of A. Our A is 60. The sine of B, our B is 17. Cosine 60 is a special angle. 1/2 times the sine of 17 degrees. 2 times 1/2 is 1. Sine 77, which means that the right-hand side is this. Any question here, Newo? Lisedi, any question, Lisedi? Any question, Lisedi? Yeah. All right, let's explain again. Now, we're supposed to do 5.3.1. We have to prove that the sine of A plus B minus the sine of A minus B is 2 cosine A sine B. So the left-hand side becomes the sine of A plus B minus the sine of A minus B. And this becomes the sine A cosine B plus cosine A sine B. The sine of A minus B is the sine A cosine B minus cosine A sine B. We used the compound angle formula here. And then we saw like terms, but which are canceling out. Like the sine A cosine B minus sine A cosine B is equal to 0. Cosine A sine B, cosine A sine B. What is cosine A sine B plus cosine? It's 2 cosine A sine B, which is the right-hand side. Now, in 5.3.2, it's easy. They wanted us to just determine the sine of 77 minus the sine of 43. So it's very easy, very straightforward. So now, if you have you let the left-hand side be sine 77 minus the sine of 43. 77 is 60 plus 17, and the 43 is 60 minus 17. So it is 2 cosine A sine B. The A is 60. So that here you actually have exactly, according to this formula, this is equal to 2 cosine A sine B. So A is 60. So you have cosine 60. The sign of B, our B is 17, 17. We have the sign of 17. What is cosine 60? Right, using a calculator, a special angle, or using special triangles is 1/2. 2 times 1/2 is 1, giving us the sine of 17, which is the right-hand side. Which gives us the right-hand side. Any question? So we've proven, therefore, that sine 77 minus sine 43 is equal to sine 17 degrees. It's equal to sine 17 degrees. It's equal to sine 17 degrees. Right, any question on this? Right, any question on these things here? Right, so we continue. Any question? We continue. We continue. We continue. Next question. Cosine 26. Given that cosine 26 is m, without using calculator, determine the 2 sine squared of 77 degrees in terms of m. In terms of m. Okay, yeah, please inform me in the chat what the answer is, but please don't use a calculator. Please don't use a calculator. Right. Please don't use a calculator. Right, when you're done, so send your answer on the charts. When you're done, please send the answer on the charts. When you're done, please send the answer on the chat. When you're done, please send the answer on the chat. Right. Right. We continue. Right. Okay, yeah, because I've done an example. So, but you see here, you must remember some double angles. You must remember if they give you two sine squared, okay, you use the double angle, yeah? Which is cosine 2x is 1 minus 2 sine squared. Then what answer did you get? What answer did you get? Okay. Let me give you a few more minutes. Finish up, please. Then we shall do the corrections. Then we shall do corrections. We shall do corrections. Right, we shall do corrections. Right, then we shall do corrections. Right, when you're done, then we'll continue. Right. Don't run. Don't break your fingers. Take your time. Okay, let's see what you've got. Right, so let us see what we have here as a matter of fact, and see what can actually be achieved here, because we have been given the cosine of 26 degrees. But 26 degrees is the same as 2 times 13. Want to see the connection with 77 degrees? So 90 degrees minus 77 degrees is what? Is 13 degrees. Is 13 degrees. Right, so you are able to see actually the connection between these. So now, to be able to get the sine of 77 degrees, you can actually think of the fact that okay, let me give you a chance then, because you realized something. You realized something. Right, you realize something. Let's give you a chance. Okay, let's see what you have got. Okay, that's a good question. Is it M over 2? That's a good question. Is it exactly M over 2? Let us think about it and check if it is M over 2 or not. Right, is it M over 2? It is M plus 1. I'm just telling you, it is M plus 1. So, which means that we have two sine square of 77. Minus 13 degrees. Right, which is 90 minus 13 is exactly the same as the 77. That's another way to do it. 90 degrees minus 13 is the same as 9 degrees minus 13 is the same as 77 degrees. So 77 degrees is the same as 90 minus 13. You can put a square on top. 90 minus is in the first quadrant where all the trig ratios are positive, but then it changes to its curve function, giving us the cosine of 13 degrees. So what then do we achieve out of this? Right, what then do you achieve out of this? Right. So this is the same as what? 2 cosine square of 13 degrees, which is the same as 2 cosine square of 13 degrees minus 1 plus 1. Now, 2 cosine squared, cosine 2x is 2 cosine squared minus 1, which is cosine 2 times 13. Right. Okay, so yeah, cosine 26 is the same as m plus 1. M plus 1. So the answer is m plus 1. Okay, this is one way to do it, but there are many other ways to do it. There are many other ways to do it. Any question? Right, if you have a question, please let us know. If you have a question, please let us know. If you have a question, please let us know. If you have a question, please let us know. Okay. Make sure you understand what we are doing. Okay, I'm slowing down because I don't want to just run through the questions. Right. Okay. We continue. We continue. All right, let's move on to the next one. Shall we move to the next one? This one here, I'm giving you like 4 minutes to try this one, then we shall discuss the corrections. I'm giving you 4 minutes, then we shall discuss the corrections. Right. Then we shall discuss the corrections. So we continue. Right. Okay, yeah, I'll give you a chance to practice. We continue. Right, you try, and then we shall do the corrections. But again, please, you don't use a calculator. So, no calculator without using a calculator. Why do you continue? Right. We continue. We continue. Right. Let us know how far you've gone. Okay, that's fine. Excellent stuff. So we have the sine squared of 35 degrees minus cosine squared of 35 degrees. The sine of 10 cosine 10 degrees. 35 minus sine squared of 35 degrees. Okay, you can write, break it down like this. But you remember that cosine 2x is cosine squared x minus sine squared x. Cosine squared minus sine squared is the same as minus cosine 2 times 35. Two times 10. 2 times 35 is 70. The sine of 20. And 20 and 70 are called complementary angles. Complementary angles. Cosine 70 is the same as 90 minus 20 degrees. The sine of 20 answer is minus 1/2. The answer is minus 1/2. Right, so this is the answer to the question. Make sure you think about it. Make sure you think about it. Right. Continue. So we continue. Any question? Okay, we are slow to make sure that you understand everything. But if you have a question, please let us know. If you have a question, please let us know. Right. You have a question, please let us know. Right. Please let us know. If there's something we do not understand, please alert us. Continue. Right. Okay. Good. Yeah, that's the question. Why is it negative? Yeah, why is sine squared negative? Because we factored out a negative out of this. So if we have, if somebody says there's x squared minus y squared, and we factor out negative, the y becomes positive and then the x becomes negative because negative times negative still is a plus. Negative times the y squared becomes negative y squared. Becomes exactly negative y squared. Negative times the y squared becomes negative y squared, and negative times the x squared becomes exactly x squared. Think about it, because I'm going to ask you another one. Think about it, because I'm going to ask you another one. Think about it, because I'm going to ask you another one. Another one is coming to you as a quiz just now. So get ready, because there's another quiz for you that is like this. Right. Make sure you understand. We're not running here. We're here for the next 2 hours. So there's no hurry. We're going to learn until we are tired. Right. We continue. We continue. We continue. Right, make sure you understand what is happening because very soon a quiz is coming for you. Very soon a quiz is coming for you. Very soon, there's another question for you. Okay, here comes your quiz. In the next 1 minute, I'm going to move to the quiz. So make sure you understand this one. If you don't understand, send a chat message asking your question. Don't understand? Send a chat message asking your question. Because we are moving now to another question. Moving now to another question. I'm taking time. I'm not running. I'm not running. I'm slowing down because I want to make sure you have a chance to understand. To understand. Right, a chance to understand. A chance to understand. So take your time. Make sure the example given is very clear enough. As I indicated, that if you have x squared minus y squared and you factor out a negative, then it's exactly the same as the negative being factored out. The y is going to have a positive in front, and then the x is going to attain the negative there. If you distribute again and you open up the brackets, negative times the y squared is going to be negative y squared, negative times negative x squared is x squared. So that is the answer. That becomes the answer. Okay, let's here comes your quiz. Here comes your quiz. Yeah, here's your quiz. Prove the following identity. Prove the following identity. Prove the following identity. Right. Please let us know when you're done. So we continue. Okay, We continue. Please let us know when you're done. Okay, let's give you this one. Try this one. Right. Try this one. Right. Right. Continue. How far? Right, given x plus 1 over x equals 3 cosine A, and x squared plus 1 over x squared equals 2. Okay, that's fine. Okay, because I want you to do 6.4. There are many questions we have here, but given x plus 1 over x equals 3 cosine A, and x squared plus 1 over x squared equals 2, determine the value of cosine 2A without using a calculator. Without using a calculator. Right. We continue. We continue.
So it's complicated.
What's complicated? Marriage?
Is no relationship.
I'm still in the market because of the news. Yeah, I'm still in the market.
Right, as soon as you're done, let us give an x plus 1 over x equals 3 cosine a, and x squared plus 1 over x squared equals 2. Determine the value of cosine 2a without using a calculator. Right. Right. Continue. Continue. How far? Okay, because I can see you are still trying. So now we want to determine this, but we have been given x, which is 3 cosine a. So now what we have here, we square both sides. You square the left and the right. This is x squared plus 2 plus 1 over x squared is equal to 9 cosine squared a. So now this is x squared, but we have x times 1 over x times 2 giving us 2. 1 over x all squared giving us exactly that. Which is 9 cosine squared a minus 2. Right, so can write, but you can write differently here. You can write, okay, if you have a question you need to ask, please. So this is x squared plus 1 over x squared plus 2, 9 cosine squared a. The x squared plus 1 over x squared is 2, but there is another 2 which is 9 cosine squared a. 4 over 9 is cosine squared. A. Thus, cosine 2a is 2 cosine squared a minus 1, which is 4 out of 9 minus 1. 8 minus 9 out of 9, which is minus 1 out of 9. Which means cosine 2a is minus 1 out of 9. And that's the answer. Okay, because we're slowing down, look at this question and think very carefully. Look at this question and think very carefully. So we continue. Right. So we continue.
It's like I'm checking out, you know, to our five-star hotel. Look, like the treatment I've been receiving here, it's phenomenal.
So, what are you looking forward to the most now that you're going home? I remember you told me that you've got a dream of becoming a successful farmer. Can we see that, you know, being pursued now? Oh man, I'm taking revenge.
Continue. We continue. What is your question about this one? Anything you don't understand here? Okay. All right. Make sure you understand what is happening. Right. Make sure you understand what is happening. Okay, after getting 4 over 9, you don't understand. Okay, right. So now you have the cosine 2a, which is the cosine 2a, which is cosine squared a minus 1. It's a double angle formula. But now, if cosine 2a is 2 cosine squared minus 1, it's a double angle formula. But already cosine squared a is 4 over 9. So here there is 2, then in the place of cosine squared a, you put 4 over 9. And then it becomes exactly minus Then we add 2 times 4 is what? It's 8 minus 1. So you add these numbers and becomes minus 1 out of 9. So that cosine 2a is minus 1 out of 9. I'm giving you 2 more minutes to understand this because your quiz is coming. There's another quiz that is coming for you. There's another quiz that is coming for you. Right, there's another quiz that is coming for you. There's another quiz that is coming for you. So get prepared. Think about the parts that you don't understand. Think about the parts you do not understand. Right. Okay. Let me check the chats. How does cosine 2a become that double angle? There are three identities for cosine 2a. There are three identities for cosine 2a. Let's just write them in green color. At the back of the question paper, you have a formula sheet that tells you that cosine 2a is cosine squared a minus sine squared a. Cosine 2a is 2 cosine squared minus 1. Cosine 2a is 1 minus 2 sine squared a. So these are the identities, are the formulae. So also, so right now, cosine 2a is 2 cosine squared minus 1. But what is already cosine squared A? What is cosine squared A? Cosine squared A is already 9 over 4. So in the place of cosine squared, you put 9 over, you put 4 over 9, excuse. You put 4 over 9. And you multiply here, you add 2 times 4 is 8. You add everything, you get minus 1 out of 9. So that cosine 2A is minus 1 out of 9. Any question? Any question? We continue. Right. We continue. We continue. Any question? Think about it. But there's a quiz that is coming for you. There's a quiz that is coming for you. Why? Any question? We continue. Any question? Okay, let's move on to this one. This one is your quiz. This one is your quiz. Let us know when you're done with it. Continue. Continue. This one is your quiz. I want to see what answer you're gonna get here. Right. Please let us know when you're done. Right, let us know when you're done. Please let us know when you're done proving this one. Right, please let us know when you're done proving this one. We continue. We continue. So we continue. So we continue. So we continue. How far? Right. Okay, to do this one, you lat the left-hand side, the most complicated one. Because cosine x plus the geometric sine of x over cosine x minus sine x. Cosine x minus sine x. Cosine x plus sine x. I'm checking the charts. Okay. Let me give you some few minutes. Can I just let me just give you a moment? Let me just give you a moment. Let me just give you a moment. Let's see now. Okay, good. I just wanted to show how this is done. And so what you then get at this point is therefore that the left-hand side is the same as the following. So we're gonna take the LCD cosine X minus sine X. Cosine X plus sine X, you take the LCD, you divide by this, you get cosine plus sine, and you multiply, which is cosine plus sine X squared. Divide this by that, you have the minus, you multiply by that, which is cosine minus the sine squared, the left-hand side. The denominator becomes cosine squared x minus sine squared x because this is a difference of two squares. Right, so if you look at the difference of two squares. So that now A squared minus B squared is A minus B, A plus B. Right. So that then in the end, you expand the top. It is cosine squared X. Minus cosine squared x. Minus the sine squared. Okay, yeah, cosine squared minus cosine squared is zero, sine squared minus sine squared is zero. This allows us to have the left-hand side, which is the same as what? Right, the two cosine x and x plus two cosine x and x is four cosine x and x divided by the denominator, which is cosine 2x, because we know that cosine squared x is cosine squared x minus sine squared x. Which is 2 sine x cosine x. 2 times 2 is 4. And this is 2 sine 2x. Which is the tangent of 2x, which is the right-hand side. So we have proven, therefore, that the left and the right are equal. Hence, we can say that cosine x plus sine x, and then we have cosine x minus sine x. Okay. All right, I see. So we have cosine x plus sine x divided by cosine x minus sine x. Minus sine x divided by cosine x plus sine x, which is 2 tangent of 2x. So we have proven these. Any question? Look at what we have done. Think about it and make sure you understand what is happening. Make sure you understand what is happening. Make sure you understand what is happening. So, any question? Right. Any question? We continue. Continue. We continue. Okay, I'm just pausing so that you can see and check what you understand and what you don't. What you understand and what you don't. Make sure you understand because we have another quiz for you. A quiz is coming for you. Any question? Any question? Right, we continue. Any question? Okay, good. Let's move on. We are slowing down. We don't want to just run through the things. A pilot is flying a helicopter at point A. There, which is H meters directly above point D. There is H on the ground. He notices a strange object at point D, at point B. At point B, there's a strange object there. The pilot determines that the angle of depression from A to B is 30. From A to B, the angle of depression is 30. From A to B, the angle of depression is 30. He also determines that the control room at point C is 3H meters from A. Right. He also determines that the control room at point C is 3H meters from A. He sees the 3H meters there. And BAX is 2X. He sees that BAX as an angle. Angle BAX is 2X. Point B, C, and D are in the same horizontal plane. This scenario is shown in the diagram below. Everything is shown there. Determine the distance AB in terms of H. Determine the distance AB in terms of H. Determine the distance AB in terms of H. Right, determine the distance AB in terms of H. Okay, this one is it's your quiz. Let me see what you can do, then we shall do it together. The distance AB from A to B in terms of H. What is it from A to B in terms of H? What is it? What is it in terms of H? What is it in terms of H? Then we shall discuss. This is learning and training at the same time. Let us know when you're done. A, B in terms of H. Let us know when you're done. Right. Right. Okay, right. So now the couple of things we need to take into account. It is the fact that this angle is 30 degrees, but this angle is also 30 degrees because okay, that's okay. This angle is 30 degrees because you have already been told that the pilot determines that the angle of depression from A to B is 30 degrees. The angle of depression from A to B is 30 degrees. Determine the distance AB in terms of H. Determine the distance AB in terms of H. So you're going to say in triangle. In triangle ABD, you have the opposite, so you can deal with the sine of 30, which is the opposite edge of hypotenuse AB, which is the edge over the sine of 30. Which is 2H. So AB becomes 2H exactly. Any question? Obviously, 2H units because it is length, it is distance. 2H units, it's length and it is distance. 2H units, it is length and it is what? It is distance. It is length and it is distance. Any question? Take your time to analyze this and make sure you understand. Anything you do not understand? Any question that you have here? Well, that's a good question. Okay, the formula we used here is a trigonometric ratio, like Sokka Tower. So, Katoa. Soka Toa. Soka Toa. Soka Toa. Soka Toa. So the sign is opposite of hypotenuse. You come here and this is opposite 30, and the hypotenuse is the longest side opposite the angle of 90 degrees. Right, it was awesome having this discussion. We're recording this discussion. Right, we might be able to see you at 6 p.m. Right, we might be able to see you again at 6 p.m. and you continue going deeper. If you're going to be available at 6 p.m., that'll be awesome. But we must continue with our discussion at 6 p.m. because we must like do more at that time. We must do more at that time. We must do more at that time. Thank you. Thank you again for joining us. Until 6 o'clock, take care. Enjoy your afternoon. There's more coming at 6 o'clock for the next 2 hours from 6 to 8. Yo, see you then. Thank you. Goodbye.